Okay, so back again now. We're going to move on to our second default other meal, all right, which is a Thai green curry. You might not like it, but basically, you know, I hope it sort of just tells a story. You know, you've got to come up with your own little default meals. You can use these ones if you want, but I'm sure there's stuff that you like that you know is quick, easy, within your budget, that you can get your hands on really easily. You can keep the ingredients in your house all the time, and it just helps with that willpower, okay? And that's the idea. Pan again, okay, as you can see, through the whole of this, I've used like a couple of different types of pan. Like I said before, when I was living in the back of a van, I had one little frying pan, and that's what I used for all my little meals. So you can do it. What we're gonna make is a Thai green curry. What I've got is a Thai green paste. Again, there are gonna be some ingredients in here that are not paleo, that I would, if you're using a lot of it, then I would be saying, okay, you need to get that, you need to get rid of that a little bit and all this kind of stuff. But on the grand scheme of things, you know, with moderation, there's not a great lot. So I'm just gonna whack my old paste in there a little bit and just start heating that up a little bit. Just turn that down. Keep that in the fridge, obviously, in a couple of days, we're gonna use that again, and it will keep for a while. Whilst that's going on, just sort of heating up a little bit, we would stick our chicken in. We've got a couple of bits of chicken from before. Obviously you'd need more than that. You'd need more chicken than this. But just for this demonstration, this is pretty much enough. So imagine you had like 3 or 4 times the amount and you would be able to keep that and use it later in the week. Okay, so whilst that's going on, you think about what kind of stuff that you'd want with it. Dead easy veg, you know, you can cook that in the microwave in seconds. I wouldn't advise that because it kills off some of the nutrients and vitamins and minerals and all that kind of stuff, but just boil it in the pan. Again, it doesn't take very long, so you can have veg with it. Another thing that you can have with it is a baked sweet potato. You just whack that in the oven for a little bit, okay, just top and tail it, give it a wash, whack it in the oven, have a baked sweet potato. That's something I do quite often. And that's pretty much it. Okay, the next thing then is, whilst that's sort of cooking away, and just keep that moving around, obviously remember that there would be more of it. Can you believe it? Yes I have. There we go. So what I've got then is some of the coconut milk. It's just coconut milk, okay? So, and all we do is whack the coconut milk. I had more chicken, I'd use the whole lot, but basically I really don't need to with this amount of chicken, this amount of paste. Okay, I'm just going to leave that now, just to cook away, just to simmer away, and all that kind of stuff. So whilst that's happening, you could be doing other bits and bobs. You need to leave it for about 5 to 10 minutes, you know, you could leave it for longer. I've found that actually this stuff is amazing the next day. So cook it, leave it a day, absolutely amazing. So you're going to leave that to simmer away now, not too hot.
Smells incredible.
Yeah, it does smell good. You know, the coconut and everything. I know there's people out there that don't like coconut. Don't really know what another kind of alternative would be for the old coconut milk, but you know, if you do like coconut, it's a fantastic little meal to have. So quick and easy. And coconut is full to the brim of the good fats that we need, the good cholesterol that I was talking about before. Okay, so here straight away you've got your protein in your chicken, and you've got your good fats in the coconut. Okay. What you can also do as well is at the very bottom of the coconut milk is loads of coconut water, so you could have that as a drink, you know, just drink the coconut water because you've used the milk in your curry. excuse me. And obviously your carbohydrates comes from either your veg that you're going to eat it with, or your sweet potato. Alright, so you've got your balanced meal there like we were talking about. Towards the end then, what I'll always do is just whack in loads of spinach. Okay, just absolutely loads of spinach. Now that will sort of wilt away and almost disappear to nothing, but the goodness is still there, okay, so don't leave that. So just get the spinach in there, just get it heated up, melted down. puts a bit of colour in there, adds more nutrients, a bit more protein and all this kind of stuff. So here we go, getting there. We'll just let that cook for a little bit longer. What do you reckon, Ed? Any questions about Ed you think people will be wanting to know?
Tinned coconut milk, better than cartoned?
Well, I mean, it boils down to your, you know, your perception of all that kind of stuff, really. I mean, you know, the food does sort of pick up some of the chemicals and everything, the metal and all this kind of stuff. But remember, it's about being quick and easy and being the first step. If we go back over to the board, you know, when you're sorting out your nutrition, we start here, okay? And many people just think that, you know, that actually, if this is day 1, 2, 3, 4, that we basically go like that, dink, and live like monks for the rest of our life. Now, I will tell you now that that is never going to happen. Never going to happen, because you just can't, you can't do it. You've not put the things in place to be able to live like that. Okay, so what you'll actually find is that it's a gradual slope like that. It's a gradual progression of cleaning out your eating, and then 20 years time, you'll just be keep going and keep going and keep going and keep going. So it's like a dial that turns bit by bit, as opposed to a switch that just flicks. And you know, so start off tinned coconut milk. In, you know, 6 months time, you might do a bit of research and work out, actually, I don't really want to eat tinned coconut milk anymore. I'm going to have raw coconut milk from a coconut. I'm going to create my own from coconut, whatever. And that's basically how to work it. This is very much early steps. You know, if you then go on to do other stuff and to improve your diet by making small changes, perfect. This is about getting the big hitters. Many people talk to me and go, well, I don't want tinned coconut because, you know, I'll get some of the metals in my food and maybe it sat there for a long time and all this kind of stuff. But then they'll go and eat a Big Mac meal. You know what I mean? So this is about getting those big hitters out of the way. Okay, so that's cooking away. You can see the spinach that's really starting to melt, wilt down a little bit. Okay, we're pretty much done. So we'll serve this. Same again. Okay, so we'll just get it in a bowl. Like I said, this stuff is not only awesome cooked as it's cooked now, but it's incredible when it's been stood for a while as well. Okay, so there we go. Another thing that I tend to do as well is same again, is just whack a few. It's a bit mucky. Use that. Is whack a few. Whack a few nuts in there as well, just on the top. And there we go, Thai green curry, dead easy. You can do that with turkey, shrimp, fish. You can do it with all sorts of different stuff. I'll always bowl, you know, do lots and lots of bowls of it, stick the bowls in the fridge, and then as I'm hungry, I just pick it up and eat away. Okay, so that brings us to the end of our default meals. All in all, that shopping cost me about £30, all right, from a regular supermarket. I didn't really chop around, I didn't do anything like that. When you're cooking for the whole week, obviously you've got economy scale, it doesn't need to be expensive, and you can get that stuff wherever you want. If you found these little videos of use, then please, you know, first of all, let me know, share them with your friends and all that kind of stuff. But also, you know, if you have found them of use and I get enough response, I will start doing some other stuff. I'll do some other stuff, like there's a dead easy flapjack to do, granola. There's all sorts of different meals that you can do within seconds, and maybe that'll help you. Okay, So let us know. So first of all, thank you very much to Ed for filming this. Secondly, thanks for you guys for watching it. Otherwise, it would be completely irrelevant. And keep me informed on how you're getting on. Take care.